Hey guys, for today's video build, we're going to be doing a sound system in this 2001 Pontiac Montana. Now, a lot of you may be saying, why would you do that in a minivan? It's so not cool. Yes and no. My only problem is, a lot of these people own SUVs, AUVs, I don't know what else they call it. Well, you can all FO. Because station wagons and minivans have a stigma to them. Well, station wagons are coming back, but minivans have a stigma, and SUVs don't. And I'm going to show you something really quick that might make you think a little bit. This is the body line of a station wagon or a minivan. Very rectangular, very square. We call this the minivan uncool line. However, on a SUV, all the new ones, they're similar, but all they do is they rake the roof, they slant it at the back this way, and then they slant it again this way, creating more of an aggressive angle. So we call this the SUV I'm cool and trendy but practical line. I just find it weird that people think that the SUV is cooler than this, but it's almost the same thing. Well, anyways, let's go on the sound system. For today's project, I decided to build something that would be custom but has a relatively universal application. I see a lot of people buy these center consoles from Canadian Tire, and they work pretty well, and you can make them match the vehicle, and they don't look bad. The problem that I have with this is they're really low, so by putting the enclosure underneath these, we actually make it more functional. So basically what I did was, it looks like a skateboard essentially. And what we have here is an enclosure, just a regular rectangle with the sides routed out, and then I stacked the sides over here, because a lot of you guys are stacking, I figured I'd just give it a shot, and I mimicked the curve that this console has to bring it all the way down. I figured I want to try to make it all out of wood as opposed to doing fiberglass. You see I have two W3 6-inch subwoofers in here, and we pretty much have the air volume that we need. I don't expect this to be that loud of a system. I expect it to just sound like a very good complementing bass sound that we're going to get out of this. I'm hoping it be the equivalent to a regular 10 in a sealed enclosure, but I couldn't build an enclosure this narrow with a 10-inch sub. The 6-inch subs fit perfectly from JL, and I was actually able to wrap this in one piece of carpet, so there are no seam lines. Like, it's routed up here to accommodate the console, and it was a good place to staple everything. It's all glued. The hardest part I had was actually getting this curve, because it wants to bunch up. And then inside here, I was able to stretch it all and bring it back in. It looks more finished. I know no one's ever going to see it, but I wanted to attempt to do it all in one piece of carpet. Keep in mind, in this video, I'm just showing the finished product. If you're looking for how-to videos, make sure to check out my how-to section on my channel, where I go over in detail how to do different things like install amplifiers, speakers, and head units. So under the hood here, I put the fuse holder on this brace, mainly because I wanted this to be very accessible, and there's really nowhere else aesthetically to put this fuse holder without digging deep, and then that really creates a problem with serviceability. And this still looks fine over here. And you see here that I've ran within about just under a foot from the fuse to the main source in the battery. We do have a proper GM side post adapter on there. You can see here that I actually have done the big three, so this is an upgraded line to the alternator, and there are upgrades along the motor to chassis and chassis to battery as well to make sure that we have good flow. There's a factory grommet way back over there on the firewall, so we ran the power line with the factory lines and ran in, so it's nice and neat. The only thing I didn't like about putting it on the side, but I didn't have much of a choice, was these lines are very close to the accessory drive pulleys and belt on the motor. So you have to make sure that you really secure the lines and run with as much of the factory stuff, because the factory stuff was designed to run with this. So that way you know you're safe, because we don't have a lot of room for error here. I also want to mention that we did use aftermarket loom and Tessa tape, and I used the exterior Tessa tape to finish all the ends. Okay, now we're in the interior. The amplifier and subwoofer setup are very simple. It is a little bit time consuming because you have to pull out the seat to run all your wires, because When it's all back together, you'll see that there are no visible wires on this install because we want to keep it looking factory. So we have our Kenwood 5 channel here. I went with this particular amplifier because space was a huge constraint for doing this type of install, because we want to maintain the inside of the vehicle for practicality. We want to be able to pull the seats out, no problem, still load things in the minivan, you know, have all the seating configurations that we want. We can't have an amplifier at the back of the vehicle because then we're going to have wiring issues where the wire can get damaged, and it just becomes, you know, a safety issue if wires were to get chafed, because that wire is directly hooked up to the battery. The best spot for the amplifier was underneath the passenger seat, and I have the amplifier facing this way. One, we don't want any exposed wires. Two, if you ever want to go back and retune the amplifier, you want easy access to all the amplifier settings. Our head unit was already previously installed. It's an older Pioneer F900, still a good unit, slow to start up, but it has most of the features that I'd ever want out of a head unit. That's has navigation. The only thing that I like that the newer head units have now is they can do time delay, so you can optimize the sound for the driver, because the left front speaker is a lot closer to you than all the other speakers in the vehicle. So we put time delay on the speakers that are closer to us. That way you sound, it appears like you're more centered in the vehicle. Unfortunately, this deck doesn't do that, but it still sounds pretty good regardless. So you can see here, we have no visible wires to our enclosure, and you can't see anything for the amplifier. Obviously, everything's hidden. So when you were getting this vehicle, one, you're just gonna think it's stock. And if you're a thief, you don't really know what to steal because you don't know where anything is. This is a generic center console that you would get at Canadian Tire or any auto shop, general auto shop. And they are pretty low. So by having the enclosure, this actually makes it to a nice factory height. The reason why I wanted to do this type of enclosure was it was a little bit of an experiment, because I see a lot of muscle car guys typically just put some sort of generic enclosure in the vehicle, and they don't want to do any kind of subwoofer setup or solution, but they don't realize that they're missing out on a lot of sound. And this was a perfect time to exercise this type of enclosure, because we have full practicality of the vehicle. It's stealthy, no one knows that's there, it's not drawing attention to itself, and it sounds very good. And I like in this vehicle because the height is like it would be in a lot of factory vehicles nowadays. Now, I don't know if you guys noticed in the pictures or the above or the previous scene that I had an arc in the enclosure to let the sound waves travel side to side. The flaw to my design, I noticed, was this thing sounds amazing up front, very bassy up front. However, because the back and the front are flush with the floor, the sound waves have a hard time traveling to the back of the vehicle. So it still sounds good for the rear passenger, but it's not nearly as bassy. So if I were to do this again, I would probably raise the whole thing to allow sound waves to travel, because the sound waves are omnidirectional for a subwoofer because of the frequency is so low. That way it would allow it to travel back and forth. But I was trying to do an aesthetic thing, and because I created flanges on the front and the rear, because it's secured to the floor, this thing doesn't move. Like, this whole thing's secured to the vehicle. You want to make sure that your enclosures are always secured, because in the event of an accident, we don't want this thing to become a projectile. So fastening as well to the vehicle as possible is the safest thing that we can do when we're building these things. Well, as far as sound goes, it is very bassy, and I left the factory speakers in because they were fine. They actually weren't blown or anything, and providing them with more power, it sounds a lot better. Now, unfortunately, I can't play the system for you guys to hear. A lot of people keep on asking me to play the system. Well, unless you have these exact same speakers, this vehicle, this sub, and this amp, whatever you're watching this video on will never sound like this van, because you're probably watching this on your cell phone or your laptop, and you have those like little tiny speakers. Don't expect to hear that the bass that this thing produces on your laptop. I don't know why you would think that. So how I think this thing sounds, it sounds like, that's the onboard air compressor. What this thing sounds like is, sounds a lot cleaner and deeper than any factory system that I've heard, like the Alpine system and the Dodge Rams. It still sounds better than that, even though I have the factory speakers. The main thing is, this can process sound better than that system can, and I believe that this has a better amplifier. Even though that Alpine system is pretty decent, this little Kenwood is a better setup. And the build quality of the 6-inch JLW3s just surpasses that factory sub in that Alpine system. I'm just comparing it to, that's the best factory amplified system I see on a mass scale. that has come out for a while. And, you know, I always try to benchmark these micro and stealth systems to that, because if I'm not beating those systems, there's no point of doing this. And we easily do that because we have the functionality. We know we have Bluetooth in this vehicle, USB connectivity in the glove box, navigation, and we have a subwoofer set up, and we've amplified the speakers, and we've maintained the practicality of the vehicle, which is the biggest thing, because a lot of people want music, and but they don't want to see it. That's the way custom is now. Like, no one, if anyone tells you that cardio is dying, it's not. It's just changing. The only thing that's changed is everyone that's buying cardio now has families. So not only do I have to help reintroduce car audio to the younger generation, but the people that had it before don't want to see it anymore, but they want to hear it, and they don't want to be as loud. So there's still a lot of fabrication involved. It's just different now. Well, guys, hopefully you got to see something a little bit different and find something interesting to give you new ideas on how to do a sound system, and know that you can get good sound quality and good output from something that's very compact and very practical. To check out more things, make sure to check out my YouTube channel, AnthonyJ350. Also, make sure to check out all my social media. It's all AnthonyJ350, and my website, www.gofasthavefun.ca.